This is the heart of the internet, Loudoun County, Virginia. A third of all the online information is traveling through the fiber optic cables under all these data centers. Data center there, there's a data center there. They're going up all around us right here. So we've been conditioned to think that all of this happens in some cloud far, far away, but it is very, very real, happening right here in the physical world, and could be coming to a town near you sometime soon.
This is America's data center explosion. Clustered over just a few square miles in Northern Virginia, hundreds of these massive structures store and deliver our videos, social feeds, photos, websites, project files, and increasingly our AI processes. It's all happening here because Loudoun is rated by FEMA as one of the most resilient counties in terms of hazards near Washington, D.C., and the 2,000 federal agencies headquartered there, who are big users of data. Plus, it has the space to build, with a significantly lower population density than the other counties ringing D.C.
Welcome.
In the 1990s, it was one of the internet's original primary nodes, the MAE East Network Access Point. Although things are much more distributed now, with dense bundles of underground fiber optic cables serving ultra-fast, low-latency connections between the region's growing data centers and all of our devices around the world via lines running along the ocean floor. But the main reason why Loudoun County went all in on data centers is that they pay taxes. A lot of taxes.
This year, we'll get about $750 million in local tax revenue. There's nothing out there that we've ever seen that generates the tax revenue that a data center does. We have about 31 million square feet right now, with another 4 million that's currently under development. And we'll probably top out around 40 million square feet or so. We jumped in early, and since then, you know, it's been a really good ride for us.
But there's a cost. These industrial facilities are ugly and impact neighborhoods. News story after news story features residents complaining about how noisy they are. So I scouted out the public places closest to them to get an accurate sense of how much of a problem this actually is.
This is an AWS data center. I'm about 100 feet away from it, I would say. It's about as close as any homes or apartments are gonna be. And I can barely hear it. There's actually a plane going overhead right now, definitely making more noise than the data center. A lot of them are a lot taller than this, so this one isn't that imposing on the neighborhood. But I mean, this is the second plane that's passed overhead since I've been standing here for a minute, 2 minutes. So that's definitely more of a noise issue right by Dulles in Loudoun County than to me than the data centers.
So even though the data center takeover here was quite jarring when I first saw it, Loudoun County overall seems to have done a pretty good job limiting them to industrial and commercial zones where they're minimally disruptive. Okay, they may have gone a little overboard. Now that Loudoun's nearly saturated, developers are building them throughout the region. In neighboring Prince William County and Frederick, across the Potomac in Maryland, they're going big. Each county will see vast 2,000-acre swaths of farmland turn into campuses, with more than 20 million square feet of data centers. Frederick's mega project is putting a brownfield site to good use, a former aluminum smelting plant. The Prince William campus is closer to more sensitive areas and larger housing developments. Both locations share the same central challenge. They have to bring a lot of energy in to run and cool them. As this hourly map of electricity imports and exports shows, both Virginia and Maryland are already big net importers of electricity in the 11-state regional transmission organization called PJM. And these new data center campuses will add hundreds more megawatts to their loads. This comes on top of our push to electrify the entire transportation industry and the HVAC systems in every building. So to make sure everyone has enough power, PJM has contracted the building of new high-voltage transmission lines, including a 70-mile line cutting through Baltimore, Carroll, and Frederick counties called the Maryland-Piedmont Reliability Project, or MPRP.
People are pretty upset about it. Nobody wants something like this running through their property.
When you come to our property, we will fight you off.
They're also asking another good question. What's behind this sudden growth in data centers creeping in and transmission lines running throughout their state? The reason, of course, behind a lot of it is the AI boom. A ChatGPT prompt uses 10 times the electricity as a normal Google search, and Google's Gemini AI uses 25 times as much. To power all this, the energy-starved Mid-Atlantic region is generating electricity any way it can. Dominion Energy is proposing a new methane and oil field power plant in Chesterfield County, Virginia. Dominion's also investing in renewables, like the largest offshore wind project in the United States that began installing turbines this year off the Atlantic coast. Earlier this year, Virginia's North Anna nuclear plant reactor licenses were extended to 2058 and 2060. And Microsoft is bankrolling Constellation Energy's restart of the remaining nuclear reactor at Pennsylvania's Three Mile Island that shut down in 2019. The other reactor partially melted down, famously, in 1979. The federal government and leading companies seem to have heard people's outrage about ugly transmission lines turning our beautiful countryside into, well, this. The U.S. Department of Energy has invested in research to bury high-voltage transmission lines affordably. Oil and gas giant ExxonMobil is developing a massive 1.5 gigawatt natural gas plant next to a large data center campus it's planning to keep it off the grid, and says it will capture 90% of the carbon emissions. And last week, Google, one of the world's largest data center builders, announced it will develop industrial parks with gigawatts of data center capacity co-located with new clean energy plants on the same site to prevent the problem of new transmission lines and adding loads to the grid. Many new projects are looking to alleviate another big concern, their heavy water usage, by recycling it. Research is underway on alternative ways of cooling the chips. It's projected that data centers will use more than 8% of national electricity production by 2030, up from just 3% today. So even though the AI era has just begun, we're already experiencing the negative effect it can have on the physical world. The good news is we're also beginning to implement best practices that limit these costs.
But I want to know what you think. Have any data centers popped up where you are? From the snowy Mid-Atlantic, happy holidays. I'll see you in 2025.